Namaste. The Bharatiya Vidya Niketan, the Ernakulam district, is happy to welcome all the students to our video classes. Now, I'm going to take 7th standard mathematics, first chapter, integers. In the last year, that means in the 6th standard, you have learned about integers. Let me recall that in the last previous chapter, that is integers. As you know, we have learned about the different types of numbers, natural numbers, whole numbers, fractions, decimals. And in the last year, that means in the 6th standard, that you have learned a different types of number that is known as integers. Up to 6th standard beginning, you understood the smallest number or the smallest whole number is 0. That is right. And there is no number behind below 0 that you learn up to 6th standard. But in the 6th standard, you learn there are some numbers that comes below zeros. And they are known as negative numbers. And you can easily understand what do you mean by negative number. Negative number means the numbers which are less than 0. And there you studied another type of number, positive numbers. Positive numbers means it comes greater than 0. That means our natural numbers are known as positive numbers. And we are classifying these three numbers together. That means negative number, 0 and positive number all together, that we are calling them as integers. Okay? So here we are saying about integers based on the number 0. Negative integer means the numbers that comes below 0. That means the numbers less than 0. Positive integer means the numbers greater than 0 or the numbers above 0. And we are using a symbol to understand negative integers. There is a see, I'm showing one negative integer. So here you can see that a subtraction symbol or a negative symbol in front of the given digit. So this will read as negative 3. And in the case of positive integer, we are writing in this way. And sometimes we will make it as a plus symbol in front of that. And without any symbol, we are considering the given numbers are positive integers. Now, I want to ask you one question. So, I already told you about negative integers and positive integers. And I told you, the number 1 is the first positive integer because the first number after 0 comes is 1. So, 1 is the first positive integer. And the smallest positive integer. Okay? And can you tell me which number comes in negative first? Yes, it is negative 1. It is negative 1. Negative 1 is the first number comes in the case of negative integers. And we will learn about the speciality of negative 1. And this negative 1 is the largest negative integer. And I told you, positive 1 is the smallest positive integer. And negative 1 is the largest negative integer. And in the last year you studied, we cannot find out the greatest positive integer because there is no ending in numbers. And in the same way, we cannot find out which is the smallest negative integer because there is no ending numbers. And my next question. We have discussed about negative integer, positive integer, everything. And what about 0? Is it a positive integer? Or is it a negative integer? What do you feel? Is it a positive integer or negative integer? Yes. As you know that, we are saying about positive integers and negative integers based on zero. Zero doesn't come in these two groups. So we can say that zero is neither a positive number nor a negative number. That means zero has no sign. So we understood what is negative integer and what is positive integer and what about zero. Now, I'm going to draw one thing on the board. And I think that you are familiar with it. What is this? In geometry that you have learned about this thing. It's a line. Isn't it? And suppose in this line I'm going to mark, in the middle I'm going to mark zero. And in the right side, on the right side we are going to mark the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now this, actually I told you this is a line. And now we mark some digits or some numbers on the line. Now this line is known as number line. Number line. When I draw only this is a line. When I just mark some numbers on it, it is known as number line. On this number line, I just marked in the middle as zero. And on the right hand side of this zero, I just marked positive numbers, positive integers. And in the negative, on the left hand side of this zero, I'm going to mark the first negative number as negative 1, then negative 2, then negative 3, then negative 4. So, I told you, zero is our base for saying positive and negative integers. And you know that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all these numbers are greater than 0, am I right? These numbers are greater than 0, so that's why we are calling these numbers are positive integers. Next, I told you these numbers, that means negative integers are less than 0. That means their 0 is greater. 0 is greater than negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, etc. I hope you understand. So, 0 is, I told you, 0 is neither a positive nor a negative integer. And I just, on the number line, I just mark on the right hand side of 0 positive integers, and on the left hand side, I have marked negative integers. And here, I told you, this number, that means the number 1, is the first and the smallest positive integer. And there we cannot find out which is the greatest positive integer. The left hand side, the first number I have marked is negative 1. And there, I told you, negative 1 is the largest negative integer. There we cannot find the smallest negative. Okay. Now, let me ask you one question. I'm taking two numbers and we want to compare that two numbers. Compare means what? We want to tell which one is greater, which one is smaller, or the equal, or okay. I'm taking negative 2 and negative 1. Here, which one is the greater number? Yes, negative 1 is the greater number. I told you. So we can say that negative 2 is less than negative 1, or negative 1 is greater than, negative 1 is greater than negative 2. Okay? Now, I want to ask you one question. One and 100, are they positive or negative? I told you without any sign. They are positive integers. So 1 and 100 are positive integers. Okay? And I told you, for writing positive integer, we can place a plus symbol in front of the number. In this way. If there is no symbol, that means they are already positive integers. Okay, here compare these two, 1 and 100. Which one is the greater number? 100 is the greater number. So we can write 1 is less than 100. Am I right? Now listen here. I'm taking two numbers, negative 100 and negative 1. Negative 100 and negative 1. Here can you compare these two? Yes, here negative 1 is the largest number. So I told you in the case of negative integers, negative 1 is the greatest number. Okay, so we can write negative 100 is less than negative 1. Okay, now I'm going to give you some questions that we discussed. Listen, I'm taking negative 5 and negative 25. Negative 5 and negative 25. Which one is the greater number there? Yes, the greater number is negative 5. So I told you, when you compare these two, negative 1 is the greater number. When you compare negative 2 and negative 3, negative 2 is the greater number. And when you compare this negative 3 and negative 4, negative 3 is the greater number. And when you compare negative 4 and negative 2, negative 2 is the greater number. I hope you understand how will you find out or how will you compare the negative integers. Then my question is, negative 10 and 10, which one is the greater number here? Yes, 10. Because negative numbers are less than 0. The numbers that comes below 0 are called negative integers. But in the case of positive number, it comes above 0. So when you compare negative and positive integer, it is sure that positive integer will be the greater number there. Okay, so this is the way of comparison of negative integers and positive integers. I hope you understood all this stuff. Okay. Now, I'm going to draw another number line. On that number line, I will write the temperature of some places and I will mark some places there, and you have to find out what is the temperature in each place. So, middle, I told you it is 0. Okay? Now, I have just marked the numbers 0, 5, 10, 15, but I have made smaller numbers in between 0 and 5. That means I just divided 0 and 5, in between 0 and 5 equal 5 divisions. So you know that which is this number. Since it is 0 and this is 5, you know that what number comes here? 1, positive 1. Okay, then 2, 3, 4, 5. Here 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You can easily identify. And here after 0, this number will come here on the left hand side. That is negative 1. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5. So I just avoid that to write down. And only I just have written negative 5, negative 10, and negative 15. Okay. Now I'm going to mark some places. So this is the temperature. This is the number line that contains the temperature of different places. Okay. So I'm marking some places. So this number represents the temperature of a particular day, on a particular day, the temperature on a particular day in Jammu. Okay? And
this is for Srinagar. This is for Ooty. And this is for Bengaluru. So, my question is, so I told you, this number line represents the temperatures on a particular day in different places. Okay? So, I have marked the places there. First one, Jammu, Srinagar, Ooty, Bengaluru. Now, you have to tell me, what is the temperature on that particular day in Srinagar? How will you find it? I have marked the temperature in Srinagar here. Okay, let me find out which number will come there. It's very simple, because I told you this is 0 and this is negative 1, this is negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5. Already we know that 0, negative 5 here. So after negative 5, here comes negative 6 and here it is negative 7. So what is the temperature in Srinagar? Yes, what is that? Negative 7. Have you ever heard about negative temperature? Yes, there are some places in India that we can see the negative temperatures. In Kerala, Munnar, one time in the, I think in the 2 years before or the last year, the temperature of Munnar was negative 2 degrees Celsius. So negative 2 means that much cold we have. If comes the temperature is going less, that means you get more cold. So that is the thing. If temperature increases, heat will or hot will increase. Okay. Now my next question is, what is the temperature in Ooty? Okay, you know that this is 0, then after 3 places, after 0 it comes Ooty. So what is the temperature there? 1, 2, 3 is positive 3, that means 3 degree Celsius. So this is negative 7 degrees. So this is the way of we can find out the different temperatures on a particular day in different places. So now it's your turn. Can you find out the temperature in Jammu and Bengaluru? Just do it as a homework. Just to find out what is the temperature in Jammu and what is the temperature in Bengaluru. It's very simple, no? Because by counting the numbers you can easily get. So this is the way of getting the answer from the number. Okay? Now, in the last year that we have learned, how can we write the positive integers and negative integers by giving some statements? Let me revise that one. Actually, in the last year that we have learned, a profit of 100 rupee. What is the meaning of profit? Profit means you will get more 100 rupee, no? Profit of 100 rupee means you will get 100 rupee more. Okay, is it a positive or negative? Profit 100. That means it's very useful for us. So that means it's a positive 100, no? Yes. So profit is a positive. Then if you lose some 100 rupee, it's a negative value. Right? Then above sea level, 100 meter above sea level. Above sea level means it's a positive number. So we can write that is positive 100. Then below sea level means it's negative. So negative 100. So that I think that you have done in lower classes. That means in 6th standard that we have learned everything. Okay? Right. Now, we will learn addition. Addition of integers. Okay? Addition of integers. Let me revise last year's portion, 6th standard's portion. Because in the last section of integers there, addition and subtraction of integers. Here also it's needed. So let me help you how to add the integers. you know what is the answer of this one? 5 plus 2. That means 5 is added to 2. 2 is added to 5. What do you get? 7. So my next question is, this is addition symbol. Okay, this is addition symbol. 5 is the first number. Is it positive or negative? Yes, positive. And what about 2? The second number 2? It is also positive number. And we got the answer as 7. 7 is also a positive number. That means when you add two positive numbers, you will get the answer as positive number. In another way, we can say that these two numbers have same sign. Same sign means positive. And we are doing the addition here. Right? So what do you want to do? Add the two numbers. When you add 5 and 2, you will get 7. And we are giving the same scientific answer. That means positive 7. Clear? That means if the numbers have same sign, in the case of addition, I'm saying about addition, because I'm taking now addition. If the numbers have the same sign, you have to add the numbers and give the same sign to the answer. That is the first rule of addition. So let me explain with negative numbers. Listen. Negative 5 plus negative 2. Negative 5 plus negative 2. Listen, can you tell me what is the answer? It will be. According to our rule, look at this. First number is negative 5. And we are doing the addition here. And the second number is negative 2. Okay? Second number is negative 2. So I told you, these two numbers have same sign. Am I right? Okay. So what you want to do is add the numbers. That means we are adding 5 and 2. What do you get? 7. And assign the same sign to the number. So what do you get? Negative 7. Is it easy? If you know the rule, you can easily find out this sum.